Hello dear students, today we are going to read one chapter of 9th class, the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. So let us start. In the starting, we know that Emperor Aurangzeb, he banned the playing of one musical instrument, that is Pungi, in the royal court and in the royal residence also, because he thought that Pungi is not having good sound. Whenever someone is playing Pungi, it is creating very, very bad sound. And he thought Pungi is a musical instrument which is played by the people who are just noisemakers, who are not real musicians. That time, no one thought that after Emperor Aurangzeb banned the Pungi, one day it will again come back in new form. But there was a barber and he was a professional musician also. He was having reached to the royal court and he decided that I will improve the tonal quality of Pungi. I will improve something in the Pungi and I will make one new musical instrument. Then what he did, he took a pipe which was hollow from between and which was very long and which was very broad also, and then he made 7 holes on the body of that pipe. Then he started playing it. When he started playing it by closing and opening some of the holes, the sound which was produced from this musical instrument, it was very, very nice, very, very melodious. So he played the instrument before royalty, or we can say in the royal court, and everyone was impressed. This instrument was different from Pungi, so it was supposed to given a new name. Okay, so there is a story behind this, that first of all, it was played in the court of Shah and it was played by a Nai, or we can say a barber. So the name of this new musical instrument was Shehnai. And if someone says Shehnai, then we remember about Ustad Bismillah Khan, because Ustad Bismillah Khan is a person who has made it world famous. The sound of Shehnai is considered very, very pious and very, very holy, because you can see that this sound is played in so many North Indian weddings, and it is also played in so many temples. So it is very, very holy sound. And if we talk about the past India, Shehnai was the part of 9 great musical instruments which were played in the royal courts. But till now, if we say, it is played in so many temples and so many weddings. But the credit to bring this musical instrument in front of all the other instruments, or in front of whole world, the credit goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. When Ustad Bismillah Khan was a 5-year-old child, he used to play gilli danda near a pond in the old state of Dumarao in Bihar. Every day he would go to Bihariji temple to sing Bhojpuri, Bhajan or Cheta, and after the end of this, he will get a big laddu whose weight would be 1.25 kg as a prize from local Maharaja. This incident happened 80 years ago, but from that incident, that small child Bismillah Khan came to very, very far away to achieve the highest award of India, that is Bharat Ratna, and none other than Bismillah Khan can do this because he worked very very hard and he really make Shehnai very very famous. Bismillah Khan was born on 21st March 1916 and he belongs to a musician family. His grandfather Rasul Bakhsh Khan was a Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King court. If we talk about his father Peghamber Bakhsh and other uncles, they were also Shehnai players. So it means whole family was Shehnai players. This young boy took to music very very early in the life. At the age of 3, when his mother took him to his maternal uncle house in Varanasi, or we can say Banaras, Bismillah was very much attracted when uncle used to do practice of Shehnai. Soon Bismillah started going with uncle Ali Bakhsh to the Vishnu temple of Banaras, where Ali Bakhsh will do practice and Bismillah Khan will watch his uncle practicing. Ali Bakhsh would play the Shehnai and Bismillah would sit captivated for hours on end. Like small children when they watch circus, fair or other things. Same was the condition with Bismillah Khan. When Bismillah Khan is watching his uncle playing Shehnai, he was totally concentrated on that Shehnai playing only. And slowly he started getting lessons from his uncle and afterwards started practicing whole day. For many many years he played Shehnai at temple of Balaji, Mangala Maiya and banks of Ganga River. These were the places where this young trainee could do the training of playing Shehnai. These were the favorite places of Bismillah Khan where he can do the training or play the Shehnai when he was alone. And flowing water of Ganga inspired him to improve himself, to invent so many new ragas and take Shehnai beyond the things or beyond the reach where no one can think. So it means he did so much hard work and invented so many new music from Shehnai. At the age of 40, Bismillah Khan accompanied his uncle in Allahabad Music Conference, and when the program ended, there was one great musician, Ustad Fayyaz Khan. He patted the young boy's back and said to him that, "Dear boy, work hard and one day you will be a very very great person." And no doubt, with the opening of All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938, Bismillah Khan got very big break and soon he became an often heard Shehnai player on radio. If we talk about 90s, that time in 1938 and those years, TVs and other things were less. People used to listen music and other things from radio. So Bismillah Khan used to play radio that time. When India gained independence on 15 August 1947, Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to greet whole nation with his Shehnai. And he used his all heart's feeling, energy and training to put his heart feelings into Raag Kaifi from the Red Fort to an audience which included Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru afterwards also gave his famous speech, with the speech which is named as Trust with Destiny. So it means Bismillah Khan was a very, very lucky person. He informed to whole India that now we are free. Now we are independent. Bismillah Khan has given many memorable performances both in India and outside of India also. And if we talk about the people who like him, then there are so many people. The list is very, very long. Once he went to Afghanistan, where King Zahir Shah was so much influenced by this music maestro that he gifted him so many beautiful gifts like priceless Persian carpets and so many other things. King of Afghanistan was not only one who was attracted towards the music of Bismillah Khan. Film director Vijay Bhatt, he was also very much impressed after hearing the music of Bismillah Khan. He requested him to take part in a movie, and the name of the movie is Goonj Uthi Shehnai. This movie was very, very big blockbuster hit, and there was a very famous song of this movie, Dil Ka Khilona Hai Toot Gaya. It became a very, very big nationwide chart buster. But after the huge success of this world, Bismillah Khan limited himself to only two movies. First is Goonj Uthi Shehnai, and one more is Vikram Srinivasa's Kannada venture, that is Sanadi Appanna. He said that this filmy world or movie world is artificial and I don't like this artificial thing. So he left this world. Award and recognition. Really, he got so many awards and recognition. Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to be invited at prestigious Lincoln Center Hall in United States of America. He also took part in World Exposition in Montreal, in the Cannes Art Festival, and in the Osaka Trade Fair. He was so much famous that he became world famous with the playing of Shehnai. And there was an auditorium in Tehran. This auditorium was also named after him. And what was the name of the auditorium? Tahar Mosiki Ustad Bismillah Khan. National awards like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan were also given to Bismillah Khan for his musical talent of playing Shehnai. In 2001, Ustad Bismillah Khan was awarded India's highest civilian award, that is Bharat Ratna, and it is a matter of great pride to him and all of us. When he got this award, he was very much happy and he gave a message to us that teach your children music. This is the Hindustan's richest culture and tradition. Now, Western people are also coming to us. They also want to learn our music. So, please teach our children this Hindustani music. In spite of having traveled all over the world, Bismillah Khan only loved India, Banaras, Dumarao, Ganga. These were the places which he liked very much. Once it happened with him that there was a student of Bismillah Khan who wanted to open one school in USA. He promised that, sir, I will create the atmosphere of Banaras in Ganga by creating the replicas of the temples. But Bismillah Khan refused. What he said, let us see. Bismillah Khan asked him, can you transport river Ganga also? Because without river Ganga, my music is not complete. So he said, whenever I am in foreign country, I want to come in Hindustan or India. Whenever I am in Mumbai, I want to come in Banaras. And whenever I am in Banaras, I only think of holy Ganga. And I also miss unique Mattha of Dumarao. So he liked these places very much because these were the places where Bismillah Khan got the training of Shehnai playing, and he practiced for lot. Ha! Ustad Bismillah Khan is a rich and perfect example of Indian culture, and we can say that he is a devoted Muslim and who played Shehnai every morning at Kasi Vishwanath temple without any kind of small thinking in his mind. He is a really great, great musician which India had, but now we are unlucky that he is no more with us. But really he has inspired so many people to learn Shehnai and other musical instruments.